In this video, I'm going to be milling a bottle cap bottle opener on my new CNC machine. The end result should look something just like this. I have an old one using old code. It's virtually the same. I just want to use for demonstration. When you open a cap, you put it under this little ridge here, and after prying it off, this magnet will catch the cap. It's also got a series of magnets out here to stick it to your fridge or whatever. And see if I can get in the frame. Let's see. Here's how it works. This has been opened a few times, so it's going to be pretty easy. But you just stick it on there, pry it, and it catches the cap right there. It keeps the cap in pretty good shape, too. This is going to be milled in two steps. First, the bottom, and then the second one is the top. The starting stock is this piece right here. This is the actual piece that will be milled in the video. Or at least, this will be the bottom half that's milled in the video. It's 3 inches square, 3/4 of an inch thick. It's 7075 aluminum. I chose this over 6061 because it's a little harder. But I'm not sure if it's necessary. I may go back to 6061. It may have advantages of its own. The first half will come out looking like this. This is actually the piece that will be milled in the video for the second half, for the top half. It looks like this and gets held in a fixture. It looks like this, well, this fixture. To hold it in there, I've created four little blocks of aluminum that slip under the ridge. And screws go into it through these holes to clamp it down onto the fixture. Just to show you a little more, the way it works is I have a set hole right here. This one's at the center of the block. And I just put the first hole a little bit offset. And these are sort of arranged. I take this and I put this pin into that hole. There we go. And then these four screws go down in there and tighten it down. I'll spare you the excitement of tightening it down. But when it's all set, I'll flip it over, stick in the vise, and it will come and mill out the top half, which will leave it looking like that. The milling machine has coolant that flies everywhere, so it's a little hard to see what's going on. I guess we'll use this as a test. If it's too hard to tell what's going on, I'll record another video or something like that. Maybe I'll do a dry run where it just has a tool, like the cutting tools going over the piece, but not actually cutting it. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, here it goes. Again, sorry about all the coolant that's going to be flying around.
Yeah.